1-10, so both teams come in on an upbeat note.
Well, that's another thing that Wacker was talking about to me last night. He is concerned about which team is going to show up. This team has had a tough time winning on the road. They were at home last week against Rice. They should have beat Rice more handily than they did, but for some reason, something is holding this team back, and Wacker is trying to find out what that is. He is the ultimate motivator. He thinks that everything is positive. One thing that Wacker did as soon as he got here last night at practice, he walked to the top of Cougar Stadium and he looked at these mountains and he said, this is an unbelievable sight. So hopefully his players will gather that, and hopefully for them, his players will gather that enthusiasm and play well for him. He is really concerned, but there's no question about the fact that they do have talent. In 1985 and 1986 and 1987, they won the recruiting wars in the state of Texas.
Well, there's number 86, Earl Kaufman, the freshman. He and Jason Chaffetz have shared the kicking duties this year, and he will kick off to Stanley Petrie along with Jared Delaney. And Delaney, battling the sun, takes the football and will down it a yard deep in his end zone. And Delaney there, guys, looked like the sun was a factor on that catch.
And Jared Delaney is an outstanding wide receiver for this team, but as you can see right now, he's coming off the field because of disciplinary reasons. He is not starting this game, but he will play, as you see in the opening kickoff.
Well, he's a speedster. We understand he missed the team bus. And so Jim Wacker, trying to show some disciplinary actions, did exactly that. TCU opens up with the wishbone, and the handoff goes to the backup quarterback, Scotty Ankrum. We talked about him in the opening pregame. He can play every position on the field.
Well, he's a co-captain on this team, and you can see the offensive starters for TCU, Alexander, Bula, Daly, Adams, Elliott. Alexander and Elliott, big offensive tackles, not a whole lot of experience.
That was Regan Hansen who made the tackle for BYU in the last play. Tripped him up as he went through.
Second down and 5. Ankrum picks up 5 yards on the first down play, and the handoff from Rasko right up the middle, maybe 2 yards on the play. It's going to be third down, and let's call it 4.
Good job defensively by BYU that time, stacking up the inside option.
Big Bud Orr, 93, hit him first of all.
Scott Benarski carried the football, and guys, the TCU team has been hit with the flu bug. Benarski was up all night, we understand, but he is playing right now with the stomach virus. Third down and 3. Rasko wants to throw the option or pass, pitch the option, and he gets up to the 30-yard line.
Here you can see the starting defense for BYU. Tim Clark, Tim Knight, Pete Harston, they're big. Johnson, Davis, Hansen, and Robinson, the linebackers. And then in the secondary, Bergeson, Long, Peterson, and Rice. And Troy Long just continues to come up with the big plays, doesn't he? Another interception for a touchdown last week.
Bob Davis stopped Rasko that time, but they get the yardage for the first down.
Good decision by Rasko. Faked into the line and went left and got the first down just over the 30-yard line. First and 10. The pitch goes to the far side of the field. That's Cedric Jackson. And he is stacked up at the 31-yard line. A host of blue jerseys there to put the hit on Jackson.
Give some credit to Eric Bergeson. He turned the play inside, coming up from his safety position.
Looked like that team was a little bit fired up that time. As we take a look at the replay, you can see that Rasko just turns around and tosses it back to Jackson. BYU once again only allowing 68 yards per game on the ground. TCU with 3 straight runs getting a first down. I'm sure that made them a little mad.
Now the Horned Frogs stay in the wishbone now. Bernarski goes in motion. Rasko fakes into the line. He pitches far sideline and knocked out of bounds as Ankrum at the 40.
All 3 elements that time. He faked it up the middle, fake keeping it, and then pitched it back as he was about to be hit.
Craig, you talked about this in the open. One of the things that TCU will do is they'll come with the veer offense with 2 backs, and then they will come with the wishbone. Well, today Jim Wacker decided he wanted to start with the wishbone and give 3 different options off that wishbone instead of just the 2 options off the veer. So far, it's working effectively.
That wishbone is tough to defend, no question about it. Handoff, going for the first down is Cedric Jackson, and I don't know if he got it. Tried off the left tackle behind Rob Adams and Bill Elliott, but the Cougars there to put the stick on Jackson.
In fact, there were 7 Cougars in on that stop. They really jammed up the middle.
Sean Covey warming up on the sidelines, waiting for his opportunity. You know, this may be the fastest game in Cougar history, because you have one team that likes to control the ball and they like to run, and Jim Wacker has decided that he is going to punt the football instead of gamble for it on fourth down. The punting unit is on.
And you can see the intensity with Jim Wacker, his sixth year at Texas Christian University. And in to punt the football is Chris Becker. 41.5 average and a good clean kick. Kicks into a slight wind, end over end, and Rodney Rice will fair catch the football at the 23-yard line, and that's where BYU will start up their first offensive series of the afternoon. BYU coming off last week's win, Jay, 42-7 over Colorado State. Cougar defense, four interceptions in that game.
Yeah, they got almost all four of them in a stretch of 5 minutes there in the third quarter.